Hey, it's Kaylee. In this video, we're going to learn how to solve one-step equations with addition and subtraction. We will use what we know about inverse operations and doing the same thing to both sides of the equation. Let's go! So let's just jump right into it. Here we have an equation that says x plus 6 equals 8. And our job is to solve for the x, or figure out what number the x is equal to. So to do that, I need to get x all by itself on one side of the equation. How can I get the x alone? Yeah, it looks like I need to get rid of this plus 6. What is this 6 doing here? Yeah, it's being added. So how can I undo addition? That's right, I can use subtraction. And if I'm adding a 6, then I need to subtract a 6 to undo it. But if I subtract a 6 on one side of the equation, what do I do to the other side of the equation? Yeah, the same thing. So I also subtract 6 here. So now I can go ahead and do my arithmetic. I have x plus 6 minus 6, so that will cancel out to 0, and I'll be left with the x all by itself is equal to 8 minus 6, which is 2. So I found out that the variable x is equal to 2, but I can test my answer by using substitution. So I started with x plus 6 is equal to 8. And if I use substitution, I'm just going to plug in 2 wherever I see an x. So I will have 2 plus 6 equals 8. And 2 plus 6 is 8. And 8 does equal 8. So that checks out. X equals 2 is our answer. Here's another example. It says y plus 25 is equal to 100. And again, I'm trying to solve for my variable y. So to do that, I need to get rid of this plus 25. How can I undo plus 25? Yeah, I can subtract 25. So I'm going to write it right underneath my number here. So I have minus 25 here. But if I'm subtracting 25 from the left side, what do I do to the right side? The same thing. So I'm also going to write minus 25 here, underneath my 100. And now I can do my arithmetic. I know 25 minus 25, that cancels out to 0. So I'm left with just my y here is equal to 100 minus 25, which is 75. So this is my answer, but let's check it and make sure it's right by using substitution. So I had y plus 25 is equal to 100. That was my starting. And I'm going to use substitution, so I'm going to plug it in here. I have 75 plus 25 is equal to 100. 75 plus 25, that's 100 equals 100. Checks out, we did it right. So our next example says y minus 14 is equal to 20. And what are we doing? We're solving for y here. So that means we need to get y all by itself, and I need to get rid of this minus 14. How do I undo a minus? Yeah, now I'm going to add, but if I'm minusing 14, that means I'm going to add 14. And if I add 14 to the left side, I need to add 14 to the right side. And now minus 14 plus 14, that gives me 0. I have y all by itself. 20 plus 14, that's equal to 34. So I'm pretty sure this is my answer, but let's give it a check with substitution. So if we had y minus 14 is equal to 20, I plug in 34 minus 14, is that equal to 20? 34 minus 14, 20. Equals 20. Oh yeah, we did it. All right, final example here says negative 5 plus t is equal to 4. negative number here, and my variable is in the second spot, the second term, not the first term, but I still need to get my t all by itself, so what do I have to do? I have to undo negative 5. How do I undo a negative number? This negative sign right here really just means subtraction. So if I want to undo subtraction, what do? I do addition. So I'm going to add 5 here. Now if I'm adding 5 on the left side, what am I doing on the right side? The same thing. I'm adding 5 here. So negative 5 plus 5, that gets me a 0. I got t all by itself is equal to 4 plus 5. That is a 9. All right, let's double check our answer. So we had negative 5 plus t is equal to 4. Substitute negative 5 plus 9 is equal to 4. That'll give me 4 equals 4. Checks out. We did it right. Great work. You've learned how to solve one-step addition and subtraction equations. Go ahead and practice on your own. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.